What's up, guys? Welcome to L Aquatics. As you might notice, I upgraded my light to an AI Prime 16HD, and I'm returning the Hyperjiro 100 watt light just because, you know, just a couple reasons. One reason is because that light was too strong, I guess, and I just wanted to go with something that I know that works, that I've seen other reapers, you know, have great success with this AI Prime, and it's a smaller footprint, along with, you know, I had starting to have headaches with the light bleed with that big light for the small tank. Along with this, I got the 3D reefing diffuser. I also measured the PAR on it, and I think for my peak program, which I'll show in a second, I'm getting 150 on top and around 115 on the sand bed, which is perfect for my little tank. Another reason is I got the light, this AI Prime, for $100, which is a steal. So I'm gonna return the Hyperjiro. I think I bought it for $150, get credit, and use that for probably corals or more upgrades to the tank. So I'll put my program on. I got it from the Facebook page, which I'll also put down in the description. And yeah, it's been working out well. I'll put some tank shots up, you know, when the light's on. So while I'm shooting this video, I figured, you know, it's Saturday and I'm just gonna show you how the process on how I clean my tank and do a water change every weekend or every other weekend. So first, what I'm gonna do is blow off the rocks and some part of the sand to get the detritus out of there, get it all floating and to the filter. And then what I usually do is wait 30 minutes to an hour, and all the stuff is in the filter, and then I'll do my I'll change up the filter socks and do a water change. I'll do a water change on my frag tank and this nano tank today. There's still a little bit of a diatom bloom, but overall, the tank's looking great. So I have that all blown off now, and I'll wait probably 30 minutes to an hour and then do my water change. Just a little bit more on top of the rocks. Suspended or sand, if it's sand, and drop down the sand bin. Do along with the glowing parts of the sand as well, so it kind of turns a little bit on the top side. All the detritus lifted. All right, we'll wait 30 minutes or an hour, and then we'll do the water change. So while we're waiting for the detritus to go over the overflow, I want to show you a quick tip on how to save money as far as filters. So Innovative Marine sells kind of like the cotton balls and the filter socks. What I do is I buy 5 yards of this quilt bedding mat, and I just cut them into pieces, and they work really great for freshwater or saltwater aquarium. This is what I use for all my tank. I think it's $25 for 5 yards. So you can get them through Amazon. It's quilt bedding. It's used for upholstery, and I never had any issues, and it's really, really cheap as far as how many filter pads you can get. And you know, you could change them out every other day, every 3 days, as much as you like, and it won't break the bank. So we're here in my garage. I use the BRS four-stage RODI unit, and I mix 15 to 20 gallons of reef crystals every 3 weeks. I'm lazy, so it's better to do it every 3 weeks versus once a week when I do water changes. This is a brew trash can, and then I just put the spigot right here, and when I need some salt water, let that fill up. So an update on my 120. I'm slowly either trading some of the rocks or selling some of the small xenia frags. I just cleaned up the glass a little bit. I might trade the tank, or I might just remove this blue backing right here and see if I can make a peninsula out of it. So those are some options. If I can't sell it for the price I want, I'll probably just reset it up as a peninsula tank and move it a little bit. So if you notice why I have so many crazy contraption over here, I have, so for my RODI water, I have this split into two, the output, which one goes to my water reservoir, and the other line goes all the way to my other water reservoir for my 120. This section right here, I have more valves right here, is in case I want to do just an RO for my freshwater system for my shrimp tank. I'll just switch a couple of valves here, and also it's going to come out of this line. I can just pop this one out and RO or RODI. I can make both in one system. So we turn all the pumps off. Then I'm just going to change the floss on this guy. Try to do it with one hand so I can show you guys. So that's, like I said, I was still having detritus. That's probably 2 or 3 days worth of gunk. All right, now taken out, new pads in, and I'll just drop it in there. Make sure the pads sink to the grate, wherever the grate is. Install my clip, so make sure that the filter is catching all the water over here and not going on the backside. Next thing I'll do is clean out the skimmer. So that's what we have for the skimmer. Take this out.
clean it in the bathroom.
So we just cleaned the skimmer in the bathroom, and now we're going to do a water change. I probably only have, I'd say, 2 gallons of water in there. I was short this week, based on calculation, just because, like I said, I traded some of my Xenia rocks and used some of the salt water, and I had on the 120, and I had to replenish that, you know, using my reserve salt mix. So here we are. We're going to start doing around a 2 gallon water change. That's what's great about these small tanks. It's quick and easy versus doing, you know, 20 gallons, 25 gallons, 30 gallons of water change on a bigger system. So I'm going to start the siphon. Usually I'd like to stir the sand bed around this time. Not stir, I mean just like try to suck up all the detritus on the sand bed. Just on the top side. Just around the rocks. Just shake it. Shake the wand just to make sure, you know, the detritus that might have settled comes back up and goes, gets sucked in. And that's it. I think it might be almost 3 gallons too. Let's see, we'll try to fill it up right now. So usually I use a pump and a hose when I put water back in the tank, but for today, since it's not too heavy, I'm just gonna dump it from the bucket. Hopefully I have enough. So I'm gonna let that run. I still have a little bit more water in the bucket just in case I need to top it off. And we'll turn it on right now. And that's it for this weekend. It was easy, quick, efficient, doing a small water change for this tank. I hope you guys liked the video. Please like, share, and subscribe if you want to see more of my videos. I didn't get to change the water for this one. I'll probably create a new batch of water and do another water change for the small frag tank. But yeah, hope you guys are liking the videos, and we'll see you next time.